I hope you're doing well. I'll be explaining how to create a shared workspace in Bitbucket Cloud through this video. I'll also explain the difference between a shared workspace and a personal workspace. Let me click on my avatar, which you can find on the right top corner, and select all workspaces. As you can notice, there's only one workspace listed here, which is nothing but my personal workspace or the default workspace. When we create a new Bitbucket account, it creates a default workspace for the account. Let me click on the default workspace. So it will have all the options like repositories, projects, pull requests, snippets, members, and settings. So let me select settings, and these are the features associated with the workspace. Under workspace settings, you can find plans and billings, access management, security, Atlassian integrations, apps and features, and pipelines. Usually, Bitbucket team doesn't recommend us to use a personal workspace or a default workspace and share it among our team members. The reason being, when we invite users and grant them admin privileges on our personal workspace, they won't be able to see the apps and features option under workspace settings. So when they log in and access this personal workspace, the apps and features option will be missing. Under this, there is marketplace, which is used to install third-party apps, and second option is installed apps, basically which will show third-party apps installed in the Bitbucket account. The third one is OAuth consumers, which is nothing but generating client ID and client secret for your account. And fourth one is develop apps. So if you want to add any custom app, you can use this option. So these four options will be missing for all the invited admins of a personal workspace. And the second thing is, if the workspace owner, in this case it's me, if I delete my Atlassian account, my Bitbucket personal workspace associated with my Atlassian account will also get deleted. Hence, the Bitbucket team recommend us to create a shared workspace. So in case of shared workspace, if any of the admin accounts are being deleted or deactivated, the shared workspace will still be accessible by the other admins who are still active. By inviting a user to my personal workspace. So what I'll do is, under access management, I select user groups. So I already have created a user group called admin. Let me click on that. As you can see, this particular group has the following permissions. So users can administer all workspace and repository settings. Users can create repositories for this workspace. Users will be assigned admin access on all future repositories. Ideally, this should be sufficient for all the users who have been added under this group to access the workspace settings. So I've already added a user to this group. So now what I do is, I switch to the added user account. After switching to the account, I click on the avatar and then I click on all workspaces. As you can notice, the other user is having access to the workspace with admin privileges. So let me click on this and I select settings. As you can notice, the apps and features are missing here. I'll switch back to my account. On the left side, you can notice I can access apps and features under my account. But if I add a new user, and even if I grant admin privileges, they will not be able to access apps and features under workspace settings. I'll be showing you how to create a shared workspace, and we'll invite the user to the shared workspace and check whether user will be able to access apps and features under workspace settings. So let me switch back to my account. So to create a shared workspace, I click on my avatar, select all workspaces. On the right top corner, you'll find create workspace. Let me name this as test shared workspace Suhas. So I have created the workspace. I click on settings. I go to user groups. As you can notice, there is already administrators group available. So the workspace permissions have been set with the following conditions, like users added to this workspace should be able to administer all the workspace and repository settings. They should be able to create repositories for this workspace, and user will be assigned with admin access on all future repository. As you can notice, I have been added to this group by default. So what I'll do is I'll invite an user. One invitation is pending. Let me accept the invitation and refresh this page. You can notice the user has been added to the administrators group. Now what I do is I click on the avatar and I switch to the user account. And then again I click on the avatar and select all workspaces. You can notice there are three workspaces listed. The first one is the personal workspace of my account. The second one is the personal workspace of this user. And the third one is the shared workspace created a few minutes ago. I click on this shared workspace. I click on settings. As you can notice here, the apps and features options are available. Now I go back to the personal workspace Click on settings. I don't see this option here. So we can conclude that the apps and features options will be available only in our own personal workspace. You can see here, and only on the invited shared workspace. You won't find this option here in the invited personal workspace. So this is a very important option, because if you want to authenticate to Bitbucket using OAuth, or if you want to install apps, being an admin of the workspace, you should be able to see those options under workspace settings. I hope you enjoyed the video. I request you to click on the subscribe button to receive notifications when I add new videos related to Bitbucket Cloud. Thanks for watching.